the scene from Jerome Robbins' Cats, just off Broadway. So much Christmas laugh. Mango. Oh. Stream Tiger. Just wants to go out. Uno. Dos. Shoulders not touching. Come on, get it down there. Uno.
Lucha, va-boom, yeah. Right?
So but you gotta do it right, right?
Let's
how do you do it?
It?
Ready? Say it.
Lucha,
va-boom!
Yeah.
Guys, you guys gotta go. I actually have been to Lucha, va-boom. It was an experience I will never forget. Mm-hmm. I took my girlfriend, she wants to go again and again and again.
Oh,
so.
Wow.
Please.
Explain why is it so awesome, and explain how you mix in sex appeal into something like Lucha Libre.
Well, because sex plus violence equals fantastic.
Whoa, hey, careful.
Oh, is this a kitchen?
No, it's not a kitchen. You can talk
about that. And I'm sitting right in front of El Presidente, yeah. You know.
Oh, that's true.
You know, like my head.
We'll make sure he doesn't get excited.
I know.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, like, he's excitable.
Whoa. Oh, look at those nips. Oh, nipple alert. I might get excited.
I feel something right here. The back of my head.
No, you're quite warning, let me tell you.
Okay, so it's like. You know, Mexican wrestling is so awesome, and it's so action-packed, and when you go to the shows, like, it's great to go to a show in Mexico City, like Arena Mexico, mm-hmm. and see Lucha Libre, but for me, I like the variety. I like breaking up the matches with, like, sexy ladies or aerialists or whatever. It kind of, like, makes you hungry for more wrestling, and then the wrestling makes you more hungry for more of the sexo. Mm-hmm. So it's like, it just is this really great, fast-paced thing that just unfolds.
Yeah.
And it's just like, by the time you're used to seeing one weird thing, another weird thing happens.
And Lucha Libre is pretty weird.
I know it is.
It is pretty weird. And first of all, I have to ask you where you got that headdress from.
I made it.
Wow.
You did?
Wow.
Did you take a bird and just plucked it, or what was it?
Oh, I'd like to think the bird's still living.
Wow.
But yeah, I just kept growing and growing.
Yeah,
do you ladies even
amazing.
Feel comfortable wearing these outfits? Because I see like these, you know, these stiletto type of,
yeah.
you know, dominatrix.
Oh, it's not about comfort.
You know, boots and this very revealing, you know, yeah. like flamenco dancer dress.
Oh, I wear this to clean.
Yeah. You're not talking about mine. Oh, never mind. You know, but it's so crazy. You know, my husband will love these.
Yeah.
Shout out to these boots. They're so whoa.
Presidente, calm down back there, please. Okay?
They're amazing. They're amazing.
You know what? One thing about the show, because I took my girlfriend to the show, and the audience is split down the middle between men and women, and the women really appreciate the burlesque. You would think that burlesque is only for the guys, although there are some of the luchadores, like El Presidente there, they do a little shake and bake for the ladies. So why is it, how did you get in, and why do you think that burlesque mixes so well with something that's so, such a crazy sport kind of thing?
Well, I mean, I think for Lucha Va-Voom, it works because it's sort of like you're taking a sports event that's just really high energy and people in the audience are screaming and yelling and saying, woo, you know, the whole time. And then you throw in some, you know, hot ladies, you know,
yeah.
just going
yeah.
bananas. And I mean, it just makes sense. I mean, it's just kind of common sense, I guess.
It was such a happy
It's almost
accident.
Like we're cheerleaders.
How like we didn't know yeah. it was gonna work so well, and it's like, oh my God, this is the best thing ever.
How in the world did you guys even end up being performers for this? Cause like, it almost seems like you have to, the main requirement is to show a lot of skin, and I'm just like, did
it's
you think
a real
twice?
Problem.
We can see it. We can see the size
yeah,
of the problem right
I know,
here.
It's a big problem.
But what? We need to talk to El Presidente. Is he allowed to talk?
Okay. How did you, first of all,
very well spoken.
You're not Mexican.
No, no.
Are you Latino?
I'm actually a mixed culture.
Oh, okay. Nice.
So what is the problem? Are you discriminating against
somebody
playing a luchador?
Of course not, I think it's cool. The point is, I think it's cool that someone who's not Mexican is doing a luchador.
Exactly, it's for everybody, okay?
I was talking to him, go ahead, explain to us how you got into the luchador.
Yeah.
Well, I was trained by a Mexican wrestler in Southern California.
Wow.
It's very popular, us being so close to Mexico. Mm-hmm. And my trainer thought I had the talent, and he said I should wear a mask because I'm ugly, but no.
What?
That's
no!
not what he said.
No.
What?
Dennis, go ahead, tell him, is he ugly?
No, papi, tú estás bien bueno, no te preocupes.
Hey, careful at night, all right, Dennis finds addresses.
I'll
That's
show
all
you later.
I said.
Bruno, what do you think about this color? You like colorful things based on the shirt that you're wearing today. What do you think about this outfit?
Of course. I mean, the whole thing, the color, she has ram horns on the back of her head.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's not just color, it's the attention to detail that's so fascinating to me. I mean, it really is a special special costume, you know?
Her whole apartment would blow your mind. I'm not kidding. It's really spectacular. It's like a museum in there. It's amazing.
I do love the lip. Can we show the lips?
Yeah. That's
amazing. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, look at that.
Yeah. Wow. Wait, no, I was talking about your lips.
Which lips?
This will be like, my dad will go crazy right now.
If you came home dressed like that, what would your dad say?
My dad would say, oh, are you from Ghana? From, you know, that place from all Ghana? But I was going to tell her, you know, it's so amazing that she did this herself, you know? So how much time does it require for you guys to get ready?
You know, it should take weeks and weeks, but we usually do it in 24 hours. You know, the night before, you're up with a glue gun all night long putting.
Have your parents actually seen you performing like this? And what do they think?
Oh, my God. Well, it's weird when my dad comes to the show. It's a little uncomfortable. Mm. But my mom, it's different. It's totally fine. I was doing a number for Halloween, and I was singing with some minis as my backup dancers. Mm-hmm. And the song was a little bit raunchy. Mm-hmm. And my dad was sitting in the front and I made them move him. I can't perform and look at my dad.
Wait, but you're El Diablo and El Sexo. I mean, how was that?
I know, well, I don't, like, as long as I don't see him, I can just put it out of my mind till later.
And, yeah.
And he seems to be okay with it, which is great. You know, he loves coming to the show, but you know, the less said about that, the better. Nobody wants their dads to.
Yeah, my dad's never been, and I don't think he really would want to come and see me dance. Yeah. Like, if I wasn't performing, I think he'd enjoy the show for sure.
But if
I'm dancing, I don't think he'd be like, you know, comfortable. Yeah.
Okay.
He'd be proud, but you know, because it's really a great show and it's really amazing, and it's not, you know, like really trashy, sexy.
Yeah.
So it's like women like it too, you know.
We don't mind trashy.
Yeah. Trashy's good. Like trashy lingerie.
Trashy's good for the zoo. We're good.
By the way, you get everybody hot and bothered in the audience, not just your dad, okay? If you get everybody hot and bothered. People make babies when they leave Lucha Vavoom, thanks to you ladies.
Yay!
And yourself, Patricia. So guys, we have more with Lucha Vavoom coming up right here on the Zoo where they belong. So stay tuned, don't go away. We'll be right back.
Rita Mona and El Presidente from Lucha Vavoom.
I love that move. That.
I know. Can you do that?
I tried.
Can you teach him some burlesque? Can you teach
him?
Yeah, no.
He needs a lot of help.
You should do the burlesque and I do the lucha.
Okay. No, both of you guys are going to do the lucha.
Okay, cool.
Give me the basic move that I should be doing.
Yeah.
Can you get up?
Okay.
Sure.
Should we help you? All right.
Well, I didn't know I was going to dance. Oh, my gosh.
Okay. No, so we're doing burlesque.
Maybe you should loosen up your hips and do like a figure eight.
Uh-huh. Yeah, that's a good idea.
And then once you get your eight going, then you know, kind of go. And then if you could do a circle. Yeah, look, get it.
Okay. Just your butt, though. You're moving your entire body.
Well, he's. Now you can't move in that corset, though.
She can
move.
Oh, sure, I can move in it.
Do it.
Oh, my.
Ordinarily, I take it off before I start moving.
Oh! Get it, girl.
Yeah, you know.
It's hot, okay?
Trying to get a hold.
What is that?
Oh,
you got to
hold
your
teeth.
Wow. Can you throw in a little?
All right. Yeah,
you throw in a little.
Girl, you throw in a lot.
Well, you use what you got, you know?
Yeah. You got plenty. Yeah. I gotta ask you, okay, let's sit back down, because I gotta ask I don't know if this is a semi-serious question or not. Does the politically correct crowd get on your asses, so to speak, for cultural appropriation?
Oh. What do you think about that? It hasn't happened yet, but I'm bracing myself. And here's the thing, we've been doing the show for 14 years. Mm-hmm. I went to see Lucha Libre with my partner, and it was like at the Olympic, and then they sold the Olympic, and it was being driven out and out, like farther and farther into like Compton and little Quintanilla halls and stuff. Mm-hmm. And we're coming along going, look, this is really beautiful. We love Lucha Libre, and we want to turn a whole bunch of people onto it, and we've been very successful at it. Mm-hmm. So then to come back to us and go, oh no, it's not cool that you're doing this. I want to use the F word right now. But we do nothing but, you know, glorify it. Two of our wrestlers were signed to WWE.
Wow.
And they were, you know, these really great luchadors. And they made them gardeners that roll in on a tractor. So talk to the WWE about, you know, like, we want to present this art form, which I see as an art form, you know, in its proper setting, like this Mayan temple with all this, you know, glorious dancers and all this stuff. So I'm not personally Hispanic,
right.
But I know good showbiz when I see it. I know good entertainment, and that's my job.
Absolutely. Know? I mean, I think that it's awesome to bring in all cultures and races to something that starts off with one culture and race, but you're, like you said, you're glorifying it, and it's inclusive, and you're actually, like you said, putting it on a pedestal.
Mm-hmm.
So
exactly.
People, you know, I know I have Mexican friends that love what you guys do with Lucha Libre.
Do you have any Mexican friends that bash it or say like,
no.
Oh no, like.
No, those are people on Twitter that I don't follow.
Yeah, the only person that ever asked me that was the Canadian broadcasting. And I'm like, thank God that hasn't happened, because it really bummed me out.
Yeah,
but like you said, brace for it, but just ignore it, honestly.
Yeah.
It's a phase that, you know, this country's going through, and it'll be over in a couple of years.
Hopefully.
And you guys remember the 90s were really politically correct, and then there was a backlash to it. In the early 2000s, you had people that were trying to be anti-PC for the purpose of being anti-PC.
Yes.
You guys are not anti-PC for the purpose of being anti-PC. You guys are doing it from your soul.
It's absolutely true. Yeah. I think one of the things people love about Lucha Vavoom is there's no ironic detachment. We're not like standing back from the material. We're like right in there. It's so in your face, and like you're so alive when you're there. Like wrestlers are gonna fly out of the ring. So it's like, it's very, you know, immediate. Yes. And we embrace that. Like, I think that we need more of that in life.
What are you guys like at home? Because I'm like, all of this craziness on stage, I'm like, are they like that at home too? Yes. Are they as nutsy?
Yes.
Yeah?
That's the sad thing, is people ask me like, you know, how do you get into character to go on stage? And it's like, I wish I had a different character. Because, you know, then I could, it would feel like a different experience in my day-to-day life, but it all feels like,
do you clean your house with these boots on? Is that what it is?
That's how I learned, that's how I learned to walk in them, to clean in.
Yeah, right.
That's how you do it.
Oh. Dennis, you're not Dennis. Dennis is some Dennis. Mr. Dennis.
You clean your house in those boots, too.
I know. We need to see you on these boots.
Yes.
These are more
burgundy. You know, you just take one off and I'll put them on right now.
It's more of a burgundy shade, though.
Oh, but you know, I wanted to get to the lucha libre, the luchador part. Bruno, you have interest in being a luchador.
Yes.
Ooh. Okay. Oh, let's get our presidente over here and see if he can.
Yes.
Let's hook him up here.
Which, by the way, he's...
So let's get you let's get you over there so that you can. Okay, honestly, I shouldn't.
So why do you want to be a luchador, Bruno?
Why did I do this?
Ready to go. I just need battle knowledge, you know. I need to have a big arsenal of fighting knowledge, and this is artistic fighting.
Should we move?
Yeah, let's move.
Should we move this?
Yeah, we move our shake on this show.
Okay.
Some artistic fighting.
Hide behind the couch.
I'm frightened.
Is that where we ought to go?
I'll step out.
Is that how intense this is gonna get?
I don't know.
Let me go this way.
This might get a little scary, ladies. Okay.
We need to get out of the way.
Yo, the public is lucky my shirt isn't off. I might break the camera.
Yeah.
And then Nelly's next. Come on. What? You can sit here just in case you can catch Bruno.
Here we go.
Bruno's catching.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
All right. So, what are we doing?
Okay. I'm gonna pick you up. I'm gonna show you a fireman's carry.
Oh my God! Okay.
Okay.
All right.
Fireman's
carry.
All right. Ho! Ho!
Yeah! Hold on! Wait a minute!
Yes!
Good job!
Yeah! exercising me. Oh my God, he doesn't need weights. He has okay. Bruno.
I want to exercise guys, myself after right, watching
now,
that.
Now you're there.
Bruno, try to do it. Can we see
it?
Come on. I already have one hernia. I don't need another.
Go ahead.
No, no, no.
Okay, Bruno.
Kelly, you're going to carry him.
No, no, no. I'm not going to purposely injure myself.
You're going to carry him.
Oh my goodness.
You can do it.
These have to be accidental injuries, not permanent.
All right, guys. Apparently, I'm not as strong as I think. Bruno, I should have listened to you. Guys, we want to thank you guys one time. Lucha
Vavoom!
Thanks for being here. Check them out. Go to luchavavoom.com. You can find out when they're doing a show. They do it every 2 or 3 months.